Lightspeed Spanish, and this is our word blog for this week. Hola Cintia, ¿qué tal?
Hola Gordon, muy bien, ¿cómo estás tú?
Fenomenal.
Me alegro.
No podría estar mejor.
¿No?
No, la verdad. Muy bien. So, which word have we got on our agenda today, Cintia?
We have a few.
Okay.
Which one would you prefer?
What about trabajo?
Okay, trabajo.
Okay. Trabajo and the verb, which is?
Trabajar.
And the noun, which is?
Trabajo.
El trabajo, yeah?
El trabajo.
Okay. There's a massive confusion always with this word, and the reason is because you've got, well, for a start, you've got trabajo and el trabajo, mm-hmm. Okay, which can mean two different things, okay? First of all, if I say yo trabajo, what does that mean?
Yo trabajo. I work.
I work. But if I say el trabajo, what's that?
The job.
The job, yeah. So, where the confusion lies and what I see is when people are talking about going to work, mm-hmm. Yeah, they say, I'm going to work. Which one do they choose? Because in English, mm-hmm. It's ambiguous.
Do you mean I'm going to work the workplace or I'm going to do some work? I'm going to
work. Well, exactly. Exactly. That's the question. In English, most people, when they say I'm going to work, means that they're going to the place of work. Not okay. Necessarily to do some work. Maybe they will, maybe
okay.
They won't.
Because you can say both in Spanish.
Yeah.
You can say I'm going to the workplace or I'm going to do some work.
Yeah. So, for example, if
it's different.
If you were saying, I'm going to the workplace.
Okay. If you say, I'm going to the workplace, you would say, voy al trabajo.
Voy al trabajo. So that's the going to, joining the a with the el.
Sí, yeah.
Yeah?
If you say al, and then trabajo.
Okay, so voy al trabajo. That doesn't mean that you're actually going to work. It could mean you're popping in. You're popping in to drop something off, or you're going to have a chat with your colleagues or whatever.
Yeah. I'd say 99.9.
Depends.
Of the time you're going to say, I'm going to work.
If you're a civil servant.
Let's just leave it there.
Okay. Or, I'm going actually to do some work.
Okay.
So how do you say that?
But you're not going to the workplace.
You could go to the workplace to do some work, but okay. How would you do that?
Okay, to say I'm going to do some work, I'm going to work. We would say, voy a trabajar.
Okay, so just putting the verb on, to work. Yeah?
O me voy a trabajar.
Me voy a trabajar. So where the distinction comes in, and it's your choice, you choose what you want to say. But for example, if you're going into the garden and you're going to work in the garden, mm-hmm. Then what would you say?
What would be the sentence in English?
I'm going to work in the garden.
Voy a trabajar en el jardín.
Mm-hmm. So when you say voy a trabajar, that doesn't mean that you're necessarily going to the workplace.
No.
It could mean I'm going to do some work in any place. Voy a trabajar en la casa de mi hermano.
Well, I suppose the easiest thing is, what do you mean in English? Do you mean, when you say I'm going to work, do you mean mm-hmm. The workplace or do you mean to do some work?
Yeah.
And then stick to that one in Spanish.
Yeah.
Because even it is ambiguous in English, but it's not, really is much of a muchness. It's the same.
It is. What I hear people doing is the mixing al with trabajar.
Oh, I know. That's why I'm saying. So say, for example, say you like voy a trabajar. Then say voy a trabajar.
Mm-hmm.
Or you like voy al trabajo.
Okay, yeah. So what you can't do is say voy al trabajar.
No.
Yeah.
That would mean I'm going to do some work.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Yeah. So that's what I hear is this mistake that people make with mixing the workplace up, which is el trabajo, with to do some work.
Well, it's simple because we've got the voy a, which is the future, I'm going to,
mm-hmm.
Voy a, and then you need the verb in infinitive. Voy a trabajar.
Trabajar. Mm-hmm. Or
I'm going to the workplace,
mm-hmm.
Voy al, a plus el, al trabajo.
Sí. Okay. Then we've got the I work. For example,
I work.
So how would you say I work in an office?
Okay, so there are two ways of saying to work.
Mm-hmm.
You can say trabajo en, and then wherever you work, en una oficina, en un restaurante, en un cine, mm-hmm. en un centro comercial. O to work as, trabajo de,
mm-hmm.
trabajo de asistente, trabajo de camarero, trabajo de
okay,
profesor,
so
profesora.
To work as something.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
To work in, trabajar en,
mm-hmm.
and to work as, trabajar de.
Okay, nice and clear. Now, just as a little addition to that, which is interesting, you know, for example, in England, we have lots of Spanish people who are here who've got degrees, who, for example, your sister, who's a pharmacist, but at the moment she's working as a waitress.
Yes.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
So what happens, I've heard, using estar with that kind of job, you know, when it's not really your profession, and I hear them say, soy farmacéutico, pero estoy de camarero.
Estoy de camarera. Soy farmacéutica, estoy
sí.
de camarera. You could say that. I would say soy farmacéutica, pero trabajo de camarera.
Mm. Vale. So it isn't something
I... O estoy trabajando de camarera.
Uh-huh.
I mean, you could say that, but it doesn't...
It just I've seen that written where people are showing that it's... This is not their proper job.
Uh-huh.
Yeah? Soy fontanero, pero en este momento estoy de...
You mean hago? Hago de something?
No, that's what I saw. Estoy de... As a temporary thing.
Okay, because I know when you take another role, like for example, you're the cook, but you're working today as the barman.
Mm-hmm. So how would you do that?
You would say, soy el chef, pero hago de camarero.
Hago de, okay. So that you would use that more.
I'm acting as.
Okay. Mm. Okay.
But that's very temporary.
Yeah.
But you would say if you're working, if that's your job, even though you're not, that's not what you've stood for. If you are a chemist, mm-hmm.
Pharmacist, yeah. Chemist also, yeah.
Okay. Soy farmacéutica, pero trabajo de camarera.
Trabajo de. Okay. All right, so working as, very good. Can you help us, Cynthia, a little bit with the trabajar in the past and the future? If I give you some scenarios of sentences in the past.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. All right, just for clarity. So yesterday I went to my place of work. How would you say that?
Okay, ayer fui al trabajo.
Fui al trabajo.
Al trabajo.
Okay. And yesterday I went to do some work.
Ayer fui a trabajar.
Okay. So it's exactly the same. We're just changing voy to
yes.
fui, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. And what about tomorrow I'm working in the office?
Mañana trabajo en la oficina.
Okay, so you've used present tense on that. Yeah?
When you use present continuous in English for a future event, we use present tense.
Okay, so I said, tomorrow I'm working
mm-hmm.
in the office, and you say mañana trabajo en la oficina.
And we say tomorrow I work.
I work in there, mm-hmm. yeah. And that's because in Spanish, trabajo, for a Spanish ear, there's no difference between I work and I'm working. It's the same thing.
No difference really.
Yeah.
But we've got podcast about that.
We have, yeah. Check them out.
We've got two actually.
Check them out. Okay. Entonces, Cynthia, ¿hoy trabajas?
Sí.
¿En qué?
En esto.
Ah, vale. Aquí, ¿no?
Sí.
¿Y después vas a trabajar?
No voy a trabajar porque hoy es Bank Holiday Monday.
Ah, sí.
Y no hay clases hoy.
No hay clases.
Han cancelado mis clases.
Yo voy a trabajar una hora después.
¿Una hora?
Sí,
¿a qué hora trabajas?
Trabajo a las 4:30. Sí, una hora, una clase de Skype.
¿Y ayer trabajaste?
Trabajé casi todo el día, sí. En los podcasts y en todo. Uh-huh.
¿Y mañana trabajas?
Mañana sí. Trabajo. Mañana trabajo por la tarde.
¿Y de qué trabajas mañana?
Mañana doy clases de inglés.
Muy bien.
Vale.
Vale, se nos ha acabado el tiempo.
Ok, so that's trabajar. Use it wisely. Bueno, entonces, nos vemos.
Y nos vamos.
Hasta luego.
Adiós.